Welcome. We'll be starting with the CSET paper, and what we would be doing is we'll be covering the first set of 20 questions here. Now, the first question here talks about interchanging the digits. So let's say my digit is x, 0, y. Since I say the middle one is 0, I have the first digit is x, 0, y. The second digit that I have by interchanging would be y, 0, x. Now, since it's at the hundreds place, I can say 100 y plus x. At this 10th place, it's 0, so I just remove it, minus I have 100x plus y, and this gives me 198. Now, solving this, I have 99y minus x, which equal to 198. So, y minus x would be 2. So, the difference between the first and the last digit would be 2. So, 2 is the correct answer here. Now, you have a 3 centimeter cube. What you are trying to do is, you are trying to break that down into further small cubes. So, 1 centimeter each, so total number of cubes would be 27. We have already covered this in our class on cubes and dices. So, just refer that. You have 3 centimeter, I am trying to break that down. And since it's a cube, I would have the 4 corners on the top and 4 on the bottom. So, 8 of them would have 3 sides that would be painted. 1 in the center would have 0 side that would be painted. 6 towards the center of each one, the each surface of the cube would have one side that is painted, and in all I have 27 blocks or 27 cubes that are there. So what would be the number would be 27 minus 8 plus 1 plus 6, that gives me 12. So 12 is the correct answer here. Then you have, while writing the numbers from 700 to 1000, you have to write it in such a fashion that the number does not, the hundreds digit is always greater than the tens digit. So let's say from 700 to 799, you would go up to 6 and stop, because as soon as you reach 7, the number won't be greater. So it would be 1 plus 2 up to 6. From 800 to 899, you would have to stop it at 7. So 1 plus 2 plus up to 7. And from 900 to 999, you would have to stop up to 8. So 1 plus up to 8. When I add all these together, I get 85, which is the correct answer. Now, the next question here is, pen is less than pencil, pencil is less than book, but book is greater than cap. So in either cases, I can definitely say pen is always less than book. So B becomes my correct choice here. The next question here is, you have a bookseller with the various books. Now, the number of books of geography are A and the rate is X. So, I do it as AX plus A plus 2 into X plus 2 for history plus A minus 2 and X minus 2 for mathematics. Now I solve it, AX plus 2X plus 2X plus 4 plus AX minus 2X minus 2X plus 4. So minus 2X minus 2X plus 2X plus 2X cancelled. AX comes 3 times. So 3AX plus 4 plus 4, that's 8. So 3AX plus 8 becomes my correct answer here. The next question is, you have a question on probability. What you have to do is, you have to see the number of red balls and black balls. So you have 15 red balls and how many black balls? 20 black balls. So total balls are 35. That's the first thing we have done. Now what you have to pick is the red ball number 3. Now red ball number 3, the probability is 40. So you have 40% of this 15 out of 35 balls would be my red ball. And what would be the probability for the black? It would be number 1 or 2. And you have number 3 as 30%. So 1 or 2 would be 70%. So it would be 70% of the total black balls. That's 20 out of 35. Solving this, I have 4 is to 7 as the correct answer. The next question is on circular track. The search video on circular track covers this completely. So you can just go on to the ExamRace channel and search the circular track problems. Now this is a simple question. B has a head start of 30 degrees and A goes opposite and meets B. So how much A covers is 180 degree. Since B has a head start of 30 degree, B would cover 150 degree. So I have 180 is to 150 would be my ratio. So 6 is to 5 would be the correct answer here. The next question is, again, this was a direct question from the percentage problem that has been covered by sir. So what is here is, a student has to get 40% marks to pass in an examination. So let's say maximum marks be 100. So passing marks become 40x. He secures 30 less marks than the passing marks and he gets 30 marks. Solving this, I get x is equal to 60 by 40, but I need is 100x. So into 100, that gives me maximum marks as 150. So 150 becomes the correct choice here. The next question is a question on Venn diagram. So what you have is 11 boys with hockey shirts and 14 boys with hockey pants. So you have one ring with 11, other with 14, and 19 boys turn out for playing hockey. So avoiding the repetition, you have 11 plus 14 minus 19. That gives me the number of boys wearing full uniform. That comes to be 25 minus 19. That's 6. So 6 becomes my correct answer here. Now this is a very interesting question. We have done just few days before the exam the problems on analytical reasoning. So what we do, as we said there, just draw a table. Now what this table would require is person A, B, C and D. Then you have the subject, the city and the state. So you have subject, city and state. Now once you have this table, all the questions would be very direct. So D is studying in Assam, D studies in Assam. I'll first mark the explicitly given information. A is in commerce, so A is studying in commerce college. B is studying in city Q. Now I have, check out the second statement. Second says arts college in city S in Rajasthan. So which of these have all the three vacancies? C. So I'll just fill it out. It would be arts, S and Rajasthan. Now you have science college in Kerala. So science could be here or here, but here it's Assam, so science cannot be here. So here it would be Kerala and science. Now since science is here, you would have engineering that's left, which would be here, and Gujarat that is left, which would be here. Now from this, I can just solve the questions. A is studying in Gujarat. So Gujarat becomes my correct answer. The next is science college is located in city Q. So Q becomes my correct answer. The next question is C is studying in arts college in Rajasthan. So either arts college or Rajasthan. So Rajasthan is there. So Rajasthan becomes a correct choice. Which of the following statement is correct? So D is not studying in city S. That's correct because C is studying in city S. So A becomes the correct choice. You need not to read the remaining even. So A becomes your right choice. The next is, which of the following statement is correct regarding engineering college? So engineering college is located in Assam and D studies there. So D is a student of engineering college. So D becomes my correct answer here. The next is, which of the following statement is correct? Now engineering college is located in Assam. So engineering college in Assam is the correct choice. So that's again correct. So you have first statement again correct here. Now we have a three-dimensional figure. What you have to do is you have to find out the number of the triangles. So this is a question on mere visualization of 3D objects. We have covered this in our book on nonverbal reasoning in detail. So you can refer the steps there. Now what we have is separate this into three sections, top, middle and bottom. So the top you have three triangles in the front, two in the back. So five on the top, five in the bottom. Now the middle and the intermediate part, what I can see in the front is the solid one. So one, two, three, four and five. So you have five in the front, five in the back. So total of 10. So 5 plus 10 plus 5, that makes it 20. So you have 20 triangles in all. The next is, now this is a very simple question. The dot is the missing number. So let's say if I put 4 here, it would be 4 plus 14 plus 24 plus 43 plus 41. Now 43 plus 41 makes it 84. That's a small number and I have to reach in 200s. So let's move on to the biggest number possible here. So 8 plus 18 plus 28 plus 83 plus 81. So 83 plus 81 gives me 164. And if I add the remaining, I can go into 200s. So it gives me 218. So 8 becomes the correct number here. Now this question, there is a kind of matrix that's missing. So I'll just draw it for you. So the question says 8, 4, 6. Then it says 10, 6, 5. It says 15, 8, 7, 13, 8, 4. And the numbers here are question marks 6, 11, 16. So what we do here is 8 plus 6. That's 8. You have 4 here and 6 here. Okay, so 8 plus 4, that gives you 12. 12 minus 6 is 6. 10 plus 6 gives you 16. 16 minus 5 is 11. 15 plus 8 gives you 23. 23 minus 7 is 16. Similarly, 13 plus 8 gives you 21. 21 minus 4 is 17. So 17 becomes the correct answer here. You have 17 as the correct answer. The next question says, how many diagonals can be drawn by joining the vertices of an octagon? So octagon has 8 sides and 8 vertices. Now if I have, let's say, a figure with 8 sides, so 4 here and 1, 2, 3 and 4 here, what is the possible number of sides that could be joined is 5. So I have 5 lines that run through it. And how many total combinations could be possible is 8 from each side. So that's 40. But what is happening is there is duplication. This line runs from here and back to here. So what I'll do is just half it out. That means 20. So the total diagonals that could be drawn are 20. The next is, you have the figure here. And what you have to find out is the ratio of distance. Now I have this line, that's PL. And this PD, which is half of LD, that's the lower section. Now, speed is equal to distance upon time. So, distance is equal to speed into time. And this is a speed-time graph. So, what we do for vehicle B, I have OL into LD as my distance. For vehicle A, it would be the area of the triangle. That would be half into OL into PL. Now, this PL could be written as LD plus PD. And this PD is again half LD. That means it's 3 by 2 LD. So what I can do is half OL 3 by 2 LD divided by OL LD. So I just cancel it out. And it would be half into 3 by 2. So it would be 3 by 4. So my ratio comes out to be 3 is to 4. So 3 is to 4 becomes my correct answer. So with this we cover the set of first 20 questions for your CSET 2018 examination. We'll be covering the remaining 60 questions in the next coming classes. Stay tuned, do subscribe, do forward the questions.